Hello guys, this is Sharon here from 24/7 Techie. As you all can see, there's a package right in front of me and it's marked as Amazon.in. It is the U Euphoria. I have not yet unboxed it, nothing, I have not done anything. It is priced at 6999. So yes, it is Euphoria delivered to me today. It was supposed to be delivered by 5th June and it got delivered early. That's a surprise from Amazon. So yes, we will be unboxing it right in front of you guys and let's see what comes on inside the box. And this is the Indian retail unit, so this is no review unit, this is the retail unit, and this is the final version of the phone. So guys, as you can see, this is the box that it comes in. It's written Euphoria. Guys, I'm really sorry for the audio video quality for these videos because my primary camera's battery or charger, something has died and it's not charging. So I'm using a secondary camera which is not as good as my primary camera in video making. So you may notice a little bad quality videos, but I'm trying to deliver the videos as fast as possible, and I'm also trying to get the camera fixed. Really sorry for that, but I'll show you the box now. The U branding, the Euphoria sides is powered by Sun Engine. Nothing over here. I guess you played God for this www after that. Sun Engine and yeah. U branding. So to the back, it's everything in this, like processor Snapdragon 410, and it's also GPU Adreno for 306, and screen size is 5-inch HD, 294 PPI Verlacroning 3, 16GB, 2GB, and 8MP, 5MP, Sun Engine 12. All the LTE bands in India are supported in this phone. Yes guys, it is LTE proof, and the phone's R value is this. So guys, as you have found it, as you can see, the price of the phone is 7999 according to the box, and on the bill also it's 7999 minus 1000 as a discount. Model number for this phone is U5010, and we'll find inside the box. So let's get started with the unboxing. We'll first of all remove all this. Now you can see everything clearly, much clearly. We don't need it anymore. It is in its particular same recycled box. Not really easy to open. Finally, it's out. Oh, finally. Keep it here. We'll get rid. This is the Euphoria. We'll get rid of this for a minute and check out what's all in the box, and then come to the phone. So first of all, nothing beside this. The U charger at 1.5 amps. So guys, it is at 1.5 amps. The 2230 mAh battery, the AirPod style earphones, we've seen this in many videos. I will also be comparing them to the iPhone earphones. I've arranged them for a couple of hours. I will be comparing them, and the normal USB cable. So what's inside this? So it's a screen protector, as same with the Eureka, they're providing one screen protector. Special features, the true color, ridge dialer, and yeah, that's on it. Integrated email, we have seen that in OnePlus, but the ridge dialer, the true color integrated one. Warranty card, user manual, and SAR information, that we already know, we have seen it on the box. Thank you very much. These were the box contents. Now we'll come to the box itself. So as we get rid of the box contents, now we are here with the phone itself, and as you can see, it is rubberish type of a material, back material. Tactile buttons, really looks and feels awesome. As the back pops out, this is the Saturn ring that they said that it's a patent or something like that. Yeah, Euphoria has been. So guys, as you told us that this is designed by you and assembled in China, it is not written made in India, because they told us that the first couple of sales would be from would be like this, so that the process is easy. So yes, that's a sad fact that I don't get the design by you, and I don't get the Make in India logo. I'll try to get that placed, maybe not. We'll get rid of the screen protector that it comes with. Now, first of all, it tells about some of the specs, like the camera. It is 8 megapixel autofocus, front 5 megapixel fixed focus, burst mode, live filters and everything, the CyanEngine camera, endless UX customization from CyanEngine mode, Qualcomm Snapdragon 410, take control, manage your privacy better with the privacy guard of the CyanEngine, Gorilla Chronic 3 and 4G LTE capable. So now we'll get rid of the protector. That is amazing. So yes guys, this looks really really good. It is real metal with the sort of good enough back. As you can see, phone looks good. So as the phone boots up, I'll try to give you a good physical overview. On the up top, we can see that there's nothing except the earphone jack or the 3.5mm jack, and in the left there is nothing, all flat. On the bottom also there's only one USB jack. But I guess they've also used a small microphone also here, and at the right there are three buttons. So this is a new type of placement. So a volume up, volume down, and center lock button. And at the back we can see there's a secondary microphone. Yeah, like this you can see there's a secondary microphone, and the flash and the Saturn ring, which looks good, and the U branding, which is not made in India for our phone. So we'll quickly set the phone up. Unfortunately, settings have stopped. That's not the first message that should we get. Skip everything. Skip, yeah. So as you can see, the phone is ready to be used. Guys, there can be a lot of noise disturbance during the daytime at my place. That's why I never shoot at the daytime. But the courier just got delivered, so I wanted to shoot it right now. So please bear with the background noises. Really sorry about that. Why is smart pull down working from left? Yeah, right now it's better. Works fine. So first of all, we'll go into the settings and look for what version it's running on. It's running on Android 5.0.2, and running on CyanogenMod 12.0. Storage, we'll be getting total space is 11.95. And the available to the user after the first boot is 11.05, so 11 gigs. We should take it at 11 gigs, which is not that bad. It's good enough. So it is fluent. I also need to check something. So yes, buttons and the layout. The buttons can be changed, but I don't guess we can. We cannot change the buttons to the hardware buttons because there are no buttons over here. So this is a place which they have wasted, and they have also not added a USB. They have also not added a LED notification light, which I am a very big fan of, so I will be a little bit of too critical about that. And I get it is bright enough. The display is bright enough. And what about dim enough? It is dim enough. That's nice. And we'll quickly check the camera of the phone. So yes, with everything. So as you can see, it is stock CyanogenMod camera, which we are all a fan of. The sound quality was good. Yeah, it is a good high sound. So there's a little bit of lag in the shutter. As you can see, there's a little bit of lag. If we shoot video, there's not a lot of lag, and panorama is also supported, so all good in that things. And we'll check the front camera right now. Hello guys. So yes, the front camera is also good, and there is no lag in the front camera, and the video is also supported. Yep. And if we go to settings, it is 5 megapixels. Quality should be 100% always. And video is 1080p. Yes guys, they are supporting 1080p video in front camera. That is really good. So 5 megapixel, 1080p, and 8 megapixel for the back camera, and they're supporting it to 1080p. And for slow motion, we need to go to 720p for 60 fps. So guys, this was the camera. We'll go into some other features now. So guys, the phone really feels good in the hand. and these three buttons are, the replacement are really good. So yeah, the placement is good. They are tactile, they are, it doesn't look cheap, it is good, and the phone also looks good. So as you can see, it is metal, looks good. The back looks a little bit loose, as you can hear it. Now over here it's okay, but in the middle, so yes. And the display is good. The U branding over here, that also looks good. A 5 megapixel big camera in the front. So the phone overall looks really good. We will be thoroughly testing it out, and gonna come out with a lot of more videos about related to the phone. So thank you guys for watching the video. This was the Euphoria's unboxing and initial impressions and everything in this. And if you want to see something particular about the phone, do tell me in the comments below, or contact me through any other medium, and I will surely include that in my FAQ video or full review video. I will also be making the gaming and benchmark videos of this phone, so do subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of it. Do hit the like button if you like this, hit the dislike button if you really didn't like it, but do tell me in the comments what you didn't like or what you really like. And thank you guys for watching the video. I will be back soon with a lot more videos regarding this phone.